Shut your mouth.
Don't ask me where I've been, because you've been watching me for the last four nights.
Well, I have reason to suspect that you are carrying drugs, and now I'm going to search you. Stick your arms up.
You are joking.
No, not this time.
I've only been cabbing for about 6 months, nights mostly.
And is Owen a regular punter?
I've picked him up a dozen or so times.
Where'd you take him? Apart from his home, that is.
Wherever he wants to go. Look, what is all this?
Right, you... We're given a package in the pub.
Well, I haven't got it now, have I?
So where is it?
Must have dropped it.
Yeah, but you don't seem particularly worried about losing it, do you?
Well, you're doing enough worrying for the two of us.
Right, you stay there. Mike, keep an eye on him, will you?
Yeah, certainly, Rod.
You mobile, Jenny.
Don't worry, enough. I can do you.
You mobile.
Well? Nothing. Why don't you search the car, Rod?
Listen, I've got fares to pick up, regular punters.
Yeah, well, they will just have to wait, won't they?
Oh, yeah, be my guest. Look, can't you at least let me call in?
In a minute, OK?
Nothing on the front.
This is the package that you were given in the pub.
If you say so, Mr. Scase.
Right, shall we look inside?
If you have to.
Tobacco.
Very good. Mate of mine bought it over from France for me. Nice of him, eh? Now, if there's nothing else...
But nothing whatsoever.
No, Gov.
Enough time off in you to keep us short for the entire week.
But, Gov, with respect, my snout has not let me down before. Irwin is a known dealer and violent with it.
I don't disagree, Rob, but we've got nothing. And Irwin knows we're watching him. What exactly did your snout tell
him? He told me that Fletcher's cabs were being used to move the drugs around and that Irwin is a regular customer. But we haven't even got anything on Fletcher. As far as we're concerned, he's as clean as a whistle.
What, nothing at all?
Well, I heard he was running a couple of girls down the Gatley Road. Karen and Sharon, something like that.
Well, could be something in that, Gov.
Okay, Rob, we'll keep with it. Peter, work with Geoff here. Perhaps he'll give you a fresh focus on things. Geoff, could be a good in for you. The DCR might be looking for a new co-hander for Rod Snout, now that Alan's gone. I'll ask him.
Talk through it later, Rod, eh?
Yeah, later.
Teddy?
What are you doing here?
We checked down the lorry depot and told us you left.
Yeah, got the sack. Who's he?
He's working with me.
I'm Geoff Daley, don't worry about me.
Teddy, you have come up a blank with Irwin and the cabs.
What, you haven't nicked him? Stuff is being moved in the cabs, I know it is.
Yes, but Teddy, he is clean every time.
He's been at it for ages.
Not for the last four nights, apparently.
Perhaps I'm wrong about Irwin.
You what? Why put him in the frame, if you're not sure, Teddy? Hmm?
I've seen Irwin using the cabs. Mr. Scase is always interested in anything on Irwin.
Yeah, anything that's any good.
So if this is not about Irwin, what about the cab owner?
I don't know anything about him.
Is it right he's running a couple of girls down Gatley Road?
Fletcher runs a cab company. He's not a cheap pimp.
Thanks a lot, Teddy. Thanks for being so helpful.
We'd ask you. We'd get you any time.
So what now, Sarge?
Look, Rod, I know you're under the cosh, but this is your case. You make the running, all right?
Right. Maybe we'll have a word with Fletcher, see if he knows anything about Irwin.
You don't think we should see the two girls first?
Are you joking? Gatley Road is the bottom of the barrel. We're all flakes and smackheads down there.
Oh, we know that! We know
kid, Harry. You're going to have to get yourself a new one.
He's only 4 years old.
Harry Fletcher?
Yeah?
Dear Staley, this is Skase, I know. We have a word.
Hello again, Mr. Skase. After some more tobacco.
Any time you went home. Got some sleep.
Righto, see you at 6.
You're the ones that pulled up Ferris last night.
During the course of our inquiries, we had to talk to one of your customers, all right?
So what are you doing down here, then?
Well, we thought you might be able to help us. We believe Irwin's one of your regular customers.
Yeah, last few weeks. He's not a serial killer, is he?
Nothing like that.
No, Ferris told me about last night. You think he's using my cab for drugs, don't you?
Well, that's what we want to find out.
Look, they're on the service, right? So as long as people behave and pay their fare and don't make a mess in the back seat, I don't much care where they get the money.
Who's
in the phone book?
It's on Edge's desk. 22.
This is a legit business.
Nobody's questioning that, Mr. Fletcher.
It's not been easy, you know, starting from scratch.
Right, where are you going?
So have you not been in Sunnyhill very long?
No, I've come down from Salford about 6 months ago.
Big move for you?
Well, I know it is. Just thought it was time for a change.
What about Ferris?
Oh, look, what is this? First you're after one of my punters and now Ferris. I mean, what is it with you two?
Yeah, well, she seems to be Irwin's regular driver.
Sure, that is because she does more night shifts than anybody else. Satisfied? It's all in the boot. You can check it. In fact, you can check all the books. Because all the drivers are clean, they're all insured, and none of them are on the dole.
Mr. Fletcher!
And all the cars are okay.
Thanks for your help, Mr. Fletcher. I should get back to that engine if I were you.
Fletcher might be a player, but he is not in the same league as Irwin.
I'm not saying he is. But whether he's at it or not, why bother with two street girls? Now, I want to find out more about Fletcher.
But we've got nothing on him.
What, you contacted Manchester?
What is the point? He hasn't got a record.
Well, there might be a whisper off the record, Rod. I've got good contacts up there. See what you can find out about the two girls. All right.
Did you get anything from Manchester, then?
Fletcher's cabs were on the level, but they reckon they're into drugs and vice. Did a runner when we got close to them. What you come up with?
Well, nothing on Jenny Ferris. The Karen is a Karen Hayes. She lives on Doral Road. Usual story. Broken home. Petty criminal since she was 15. Shoplifting, prostitution, a few drugs here and there. Caution in Sunhill and all the rest in Manchester.
What about a cross-reference? Try,
Known associates?
Yep. There you go, Sharna Beckwith. Ah. Looks like Karen and Sharna have been partners in crime since school days.
So you reckon they're worth a pull?
Unfortunate phrase, Rod. But Fletcher and the girls are from Manchester. They rent a flat from him, and they both got previous for drugs.
Yeah, but there is nothing to link the girls to Irwin.
Well, we won't know till we've talked to them, will we?
Yeah?
DS Daley, DC's case, Sunil. Sorry to wake you up.
Do you mind if we come in?
Why?
Well, we'll talk about that when we're inside, won't we?
Oh, the hell! It's the police, Karen. They just walked in. What do you want?
How long have you been in Sunil?
5 months. Why?
Where from?
Manchester.
Where in Manchester?
Salford. Look, what do you want? What do you think you're doing? You
your
need
child.
A for this.
What?
Yeah. How old
expect
is she?
Me to find something.
We're two.
Oh yes.
I'm a good mother, so don't you go all social on me.
Hey.
Listen, I know that you two have got previous for drugs.
Oh, here we go. I was wondering how long you'd take. Look, all we do is score a line or two, just for ourselves, a bit of relaxation. We don't deal.
Oh, right, so the gear just appears out of thin air, does it?
We get it off punters instead of cash.
What about Danny Irwin?
I've never heard of Danny Irwin.
You rent this flat from Harry Fletcher?
Yeah, but we don't do business here. That's right. All we do is rent from him.
Come on. What about you? Does the name Danny Irwin mean anything to you?
Sharna?
No, I've never heard of him. Now, if you don't mind, some of us have to get to work. Unless, you two want to spend your lunch hour here.
That was a waste of time.
Knew a bit about Fletcher, though, didn't they? And if you haven't kept going on about Irwin, we might have found out a bit more.
What do you mean if I hadn't gone on about Irwin?
If Fletcher is setting up in Sunhill, he's probably linked.
Oh, is it you? Stopped one of my cabs last night. You come round here this morning and now this.
Mr. Fletcher.
Well, why do you stop asking stupid questions and go and find the scum that did this?
Excuse me.
got to be down to Irwin.
You think so?
Yeah, on two counts. First, he's found out that we've been following him in the cabs. He feels that Fletcher has grassed him up.
And?
And second, if he thought that Fletcher was dealing, he'd be very likely to move in on him.
It's a bit obvious, isn't it, Rod? He knows we've been watching him.
But Sarge, you don't know this guy. He's got the front for anything. He'd burn that car just for a laugh, I'm telling you.
Okay, Rod. Let's go and test his sense of humour. Come on.
Hello again, Mr. Skase. Too late, Bubbly's all gone. Like a chip.
A word.
There's such a thing as harassment. It's better be good.
Where were you 90 minutes ago?
Out on business.
What business?
Good business. And I got a result.
What, by torching Harry Fletcher's car?
How can I do that when I've been in court?
Court?
Yeah, court. My ex-wife's been after me for more maintenance. They chucked it out. Do you want to ring the check?
Rod!
Your boy's been right out of order. And if you don't go now, I'll make a formal complaint of police harassment.
Go on, Rod. Mind you, Danny, if I had any business with Fletcher, I'd be worried about who did it. Wouldn't you?
Oi! Oi! Don't be a mug. Irwin is at it. He's too cocky not to be. But you're not going to nick him like that. Your problem, Rod, is you want to nick him so much, you can't see the wider picture.
Well, I'm telling you that Irwin is a damn sight closer than those tarts of yours.
You reckon?
Yes.
Okay, Rod. You've done it your way. Now we do it mine. And we start with Jones. Because he's the one who's had us running round, and I think it's about time we found out why. Come on.
I'm waiting on Green Boy in at 3 o'clock.
You've never picked a winner in your life.
You put us on to a loser, haven't you?
There's enough for you to go on. Just use your eyes.
No. We pay you for that.
I told you what I know.
And where exactly did you get that information? Everybody knows Irwin's up to his neck in it. Who told you about Fletcher and the cabs?
He picked things up.
So why didn't you know about Fletcher running two girls down Gatley Road?
They got nothing to do with it.
To do with what? All right, let's do this the proper way, eh? You, the girls, down at Sunhill.
Eh? Look, it's not that easy. People could get hurt.
Who could get hurt?
Shana.
What? Why should Shana get hurt?
Because she's the one who told me. She and Karen are dealing drugs for Fletcher. You don't know what Fletcher's like, what he does to those girls.
How do we know you're not putting us on? Teddy?
Shana, I'm one of her regulars.
Oh, great. So how do they deal the drugs?
You think sex is the only thing you can sell in a car in the back of the gasworks?
So if this is about Fletcher and the girls, why waste our time with Irwin?
I wasn't. Look, I know Irwin uses the cabs. I reckon he must be tied up with Fletcher somehow. I thought if you got to Fletcher through Danny Irwin, there'd be no need to involve the girls.
Well, it didn't work though, did it?
No, because you're just obsessed with Nick and Danny Irwin.
You've been a bit of a prat, haven't you, Teddy?
Yeah?
Well, you fingered Irwin, who may or may not be involved. If Harry Fletcher finds out about you and Shana.
Yeah. Well, like Mr. Skase says, I never won anything in my life.
There she is, Rod. Pull in. Karen.
Go away, I'm working.
So are we. Where's Shana?
I said she didn't feel well and she went back home.
Thank you. Go on, Rod. Heard you weren't very well.
You're not here asking about Miles.
Where's the baby?
So he's downstairs with a neighbour.
You and Karen. Salford, Harry Fletcher, this flat. It's all a big coincidence, isn't it? It's a long way from here to Gatley Road.
Yeah, well, residents will like it right in front doorstep.
Don't try it on with me, Shana.
What do you want me to say? Yeah, it's a long way to Gatley Road.
So how do you get there and back?
You what?
You and Karen, what do you do? Phone dial a ride?
No, we get a cab.
One of Harry Fletcher's. And who does the driving? Let me tell you. Ferris, isn't it?
It's usually Ferris, yeah.
Fletcher's cabs and Ferris. Another big coincidence.
This lunchtime, when you'd be on your way back, somebody torched Harry Fletcher's car.
And you think it was me?
I'll find out sooner or later. Right now, I'm interested in Fletcher. I think he's dealing drugs, and I want to nick him. Okay, Shana, we've been talking to a close friend of yours. He's told us you're dealing for Fletcher. Dealing to punters. Shana?
Jenny Ferris gets the stuff. Crack.
Where from? Irwin?
Don't know. She gives us so much each day. We sell it, and Harry Fletcher collects the money each night.
Nice.
You think so? You should see what he does to Karen. Treats her like a punch bag.
And what does he do to you, Shana?
Me? Nothing. It's Zoe. He says if I ever say anything...
Oh, all right, all right.
Karen's looked after me since we're in care and in the Young Offenders Institution. She's always been the strongest.
Go on, Shana.
But the other week, Ferris skimmed some rocks for herself. She blamed us for coming up short. Fletcher said he'd make an example out of Karen. What he did to her was disgusting. I told Teddy Jones. He said he might be able to put you on to Fletcher without getting us involved.
You knew Fletcher in Salford, didn't you? You knew what he was into.
Yeah. But we didn't work for him. About 6 months ago, he came south with Ferris. They persuaded us to join him, paid off our fines, said it was better down here.
This place?
Don't knock it. Compared to what we had up there, it's a palace.
Did you torch the car?
Why would I do that?
Perhaps you thought we were only interested in Danny Irwin. You needed something to get us interested in Fletcher again.
I'm not saying anything. Look, you've got to go. I've got Zoe to think of. I'm scared stupid just having you in here.
Shana, if you want us to help you, we need a statement.
I've told you everything.
No good without a statement.
What do I get?
What do you want?
Protection. For me and Zoe and Karen.
I can't offer you that deal, Shana.
Well, he'll kill me if he finds out.
Shana, the best protection you can have is to get Fletcher and Ferris put inside.
He's right.
Laying your daughter and best friend, is it?
Shana, you've taken it this far. Don't leave it now. Not now.
Later, with me not working, Karen might have some crack left over.
And the cash?
Oh, yeah. Fletcher will be here later to meet Karen when Ferris brings her back. He don't trust any of us.
Okay, Shana. We'll see if we can work something out. If what Shana says is right, we get Fletcher and Ferris with the crack and the money.
When you say she was giving Jones all the info, made you look a bit of a prat, Rod.
Rod's played it right with Jones. In fact, he's done well pushing this case through.
All right, Geoff. You set it up. You'll just have to make do with whoever's available.
Go.
Jack, you sure about this?
Yeah.
It's your first operational day. You know what happened to Rod last night? Could happen to you.
Fletcher's dealing crack cocaine and beating up defenseless women, Gov. I'm going to nick him.
This is going to work, isn't it?
It'll be all right. They know what they're doing.
If they get away, all you'll have is Karen, and she'll go down for possession. All I've got is Mr. Daly's word. I mean, what's that worth?
Let's wait, shall we, Shana?
DS Daley from Carver.
Go ahead, Jim.
Fletcher's just arrived. It looks like he's early.
Okay, Jim.
Sarge, they will not let you forget this if you come up with nothing.
We've still got enough to nick Karen and Shana for possession, whatever happens. Plus, a small matter of arson.
But I thought we told Shana that...
Rod, the bottom line is, I ain't walking away from this with nothing.
Yes, Daley from Carver. Ferris and Karen have arrived. They're on the way in.
Right, Karen, quick now. Here we go.
And there's a few rocks left.
Give them to Ferris. Anything else?
No, that's it.
Wachana!
He told no one!
Wachana!
All right, Jenna, you two, hold it there.
I'll kill you!
Okay.
Just come down here.
Leave it. Just come down here.
Your collar, Rod.
Yeah. Any chance of a deal on this?
See you later.
See you later. All right now, Shana?
Yeah. Thanks. Thanks, Kim.
So we'll see you down at the station, shall we?
Yes, Mr. Daley.
Shana. Thanks. Good result, Rod?
Yeah.
Come on, come on. Fletcher had to get his supplies from somewhere. By the time we get into this lot, we'll have enough to put Irwin away for years. Fancy a pint?
And we have plenty more police drama right after the break here on UK Gold when we return to Sun Hill, so stay with us.